Hey, and welcome to the Legal God. My name is Angie, and I am a little bit of a sugar addict. Well, not so much anymore. I've tried to rein back the sugar cravings, those sugar monsters, as I like to call them. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you 5 strategies which I've used to curb the afternoon sugar cravings that so many of us have. And 9 times out of 10, it's actually not your fault. You set yourself up for failure. So here we go on 5 strategies to combat those cravings. And when we cut out that sugar and actually have a really good healthy snack in the afternoon, you will definitely see results much, much quicker. So tip number 1 is that you have to have breakfast. Yes, you've all heard it 1,000 times. Breakfast is key. If you skip breakfast, you are setting yourself up for disaster. Your breakfast needs to contain protein, fats, and carbs. It will set your blood sugar off for the day, get your metabolism going, and you'll then be on a constant. If you have lunch and you kind of haven't eaten the whole day, you're hungry after an hour again, and that's when you're reaching for something to eat. What happens is, when you get a craving, is that your body is actually shouting out for nutrients. So if you haven't nourished your body properly the whole day, hello, I'm starving, please get me some quick energy. And of course, that's sugar. Sugar is the fastest energy, so that's what your body is saying. Give me some sugar, give me some energy, give me some nutrients to keep going. So breakfast is key. Secondly is lunch. Very, very important. What you eat for lunch is gonna have an effect as to whether you're gonna head for the vending machine or not. In your lunch, I want you to include, once again, protein, fat, and carbs. So fiber. The protein will keep you fuller for longer, it will keep your blood sugar stable. The fat helps you stay fuller for longer, and the carbs will give you energy not only for your brain, but for your willpower, as well as fiber, which keeps you fuller for longer and helps to keep the blood sugar stable. If you are having some processed carbs for lunch, I guarantee you, within an hour after lunch, you're going to be hungry and you're going to be reaching for the chocolate drawer. So lunch is key. Make sure that it's a good portion, that you feel satisfied, and you're not thinking about food in an hour or so again. Thirdly, I want you to stay hydrated. Often the body gets confused between being thirsty and being hungry. I always have a big jug of water on my desk, maybe with some lemon juice in it, or you can add in some strawberries, something to add a little bit of flavor, and just have it there and have a glass next to your desk, and every couple of hours, pour yourself a glass and keep your body hydrated. This is key to also stopping those sugar cravings. Tip number 4 is to reprogram your habits. Now, if every single day at 3:30 p.m. you're reaching for a croissant, a biscuit, a chocolate, your body knows that, and it's gonna say, hello, alarm clock going off, where's my sugar, where's my chocolate? So what you need to do is you need to reprogram that bad habit by creating new routines. So for example, if every afternoon you normally go for a walk and you go and pick up a chocolate across the road, make another habit in place of that one that is a healthy one. So whether it's to go outside for some fresh air and call a friend, just try and replace an old bad habit which will automatically reprogram your body, and then it won't be ringing off that alarm anymore. And then lastly, if all else fails, you should always have a plan. So if you know that you are potentially gonna be getting a sugar craving in the afternoon, have another snack ready and available that you can just grab. And it must be something that you actually enjoy. It's not gonna help having some celery and carrots if you're wanting a sugar craving. You're probably gonna be like, nah, I'm rather just gonna go to the shop and get the chocolate. So something that you enjoy, something that's low calorie, something that preferably has protein and fat, so it doesn't spike your insulin and then you're gonna want the sugar again anyway. So something that contains protein and fats, like a handful of nuts. You could do a rice cake with some peanut butter or some avocado hummus on. So it's something that's nutritionally dense and that can get you through the sugar cravings. I hope these couple of strategies have helped and that you'll implement them in the new week, and hopefully you'll be able to smash those sugar cravings, say goodbye to the sugar monsters, and get a little bit closer to your goals.